In this ultimate Gemini tutorial for beginners, I will show you really everything about Gemini. And by everything, I mean really everything. From the basics, the latest features and updates of Gemini, to prompt engineering, and much more. I will illuminate every single topic for you step by step in this video, so that by the end of the video, you are a real Gemini pro. And as a small thank you for watching the complete video, there will be a special document from me at the end in which I have summarized everything that is important for you again. With that, let's get started directly. First and foremost, you naturally need to sign up for Gemini, and you do that with your Google account. Just click on sign in and enter your details. However, if you have signed up but can't use Gemini because your account is not supported, it's probably because your age needs to be verified. In such a case, you just need to send Google an ID or driver's license to confirm your age. You can find all the necessary links for this in the video description. Once you have successfully signed up and qualified, you will land on the Gemini interface. In this video, I will be using Gemini Advanced to demonstrate the features of Gemini, which is why I will first select Gemini Advanced from the menu at the top, where you can choose your AI model. You might be wondering, what is the difference between Gemini Advanced and the regular Gemini? Simply put, Gemini Advanced is Google's new AI model that offers improved features and operates more efficiently than the standard Gemini model. While Gemini is available as a free version, Gemini Advanced costs $20, or approximately 22 euros per month in Europe. My tip, you can try Gemini Advanced free for 2 months, which I highly recommend. At the video's end, you'll get a document outlining who should and shouldn't buy the paid version, plus a model comparison. You might have already noticed that there are 4 fields here. These are example prompts, which I won't be using because I will be using my own. But what exactly are prompts? A prompt is a message that you enter below and then send to Gemini to receive specific information or an answer. Keep that in mind for now, we will come back to it later. First, I want to introduce you to some of the features of Gemini that I often use. This will give you an impression of what is possible with Gemini. Don't worry, we will get to the interface later. You should first learn what you can do with Gemini. I am starting now with creative writing. Theoretically, I could ask Gemini to write a story or a poem, but instead, I am asking Gemini to create an email template for welcoming new employees, including all the important information and a warm welcome. I choose this example because most will likely use Gemini for writing emails. After entering the prompt and pressing enter, you can see how quickly Gemini responds and creates a suitable email template. I won't read the template out loud here, but you can stop the video and read it yourself. What I can tell you though is that it is really well done and even includes explanations for why certain elements were chosen. You see, even with this first feature, Gemini can be a huge help, especially when it comes to emails. Now let's take a look at Gemini's multilingual capabilities. Since Gemini can write and understand many languages, you can also have your text translated. I will demonstrate this with the translation of my email template using this prompt. Translate the email template into Hindi, German, and French. Keep the tone and intent of the original and ensure correct grammar and syntax in each language. As you can see, it now translates the template into Hindi. I cannot tell you if the translation into Hindi is perfect, but those of you who know Hindi can write to me in the comments. However, I already see that it has not translated everything into Hindi below. The German version seems to have been done quite well, except for the lower part. Keep in mind that Gemini makes mistakes from time to time, so you should always check the result again. In French, it could not generate everything for me, as Gemini only generates certain text lengths depending on the AI model you use. Therefore, I will enter another prompt to get the other part. It will then deliver the French version to me, which I also cannot understand. Anyone who knows French can write to me in the comments if it is a good translation. The lower part was also not translated there. You can, of course, write another prompt to Gemini to have it translate this part as well. I will not do that now, as we move on to the next feature, idea generation. I am now letting Gemini brainstorm 10 new ideas for the welcome email to make it more informative and engaging. You can already see that some great ideas are being given here. For example, I particularly like interactive elements and resource hub link. I mostly generate ideas for my YouTube videos and can really recommend asking Gemini for a few ideas, as it's a good source of inspiration. Before we move on to the next features, I want to clarify an important thing. You see that I have covered these 3 features in one chat because they belong to one topic, email template. However, if you have a prompt that has nothing to do with the previous topic, it's better to switch to a new chat. That's because Gemini generates your next message based on what you have discussed with it so far. In other words, it takes into account the content you have already introduced. Of course, you can handle everything in one chat, as Gemini can also flexibly switch between different topics without significantly affecting the quality of the responses. But to ensure you get the best possible answer, it's better to open a new chat so it focuses only on that one topic. I will do this now for the demonstration of the next feature, grammar check. For that, I go here to new chat, open a new one, and enter the appropriate prompt, which reads, "Can you check the grammar and spelling of this sentence?" As you can see, it corrects everything and even provides a suitable explanation for why something was corrected. I often use this feature in Gemini because I do not have the 40 message limit like in ChatGPT. But let's move on to the feature summary. Gemini is very good at summarizing texts. I will demonstrate this with the following prompt. Summarize this news article into a 3-sentence overview. Focus on the main events and key information. I have copied the news article below the prompt so that Gemini can access it. As you can see, Gemini has concisely summarized everything in 3 sentences. This function is one of the most helpful because it allows you to gather information more quickly. I will show you later a better method for summarizing newspapers. Now, let's move on to the feature explaining complex topics. What is really practical about Gemini is that you can have topics you do not understand explained to you simply. I will demonstrate this with the prompt here. Explain Einstein's theory of relativity in a way a middle school student would understand. I have already read the answer beforehand, and the explanation was definitely very simple, so almost anyone could understand it. As mentioned, you can stop the video and read the answers if you like. In this video, I will only read the most important things so we can make progress. So now, I have shown you the basic features of Gemini, and there are many more, such as image generation and recognition. We will get to that shortly, but first, I want to give you a brief introduction to prompts. You already know that prompts are messages you send to Gemini to receive specific answers. These prompts can come in numerous variations, such as questions or tasks. The possibilities are virtually limitless. It is important to understand that the more specific you make the prompt, the better the AI model will deliver a fitting answer. While this is mostly true, a longer prompt does not automatically mean you will get exactly the answer you are looking for. Sometimes a shorter formulation can work better, depending on the task you give to Gemini. The key is that the prompt is clear and contains only relevant information. The most common prompts you will use are always connected with a task and your details and context. For example, a basic prompt could look like this. The task, write a blog post. The details and context, about the latest developments in AI technology and how they can change daily life. I call these two components a basic prompt, the most frequently used elements of a prompt. The task is the most important because without it, Gemini would not know what it is supposed to solve for you. Thus, a task should always be included in your prompt. You add details and context to make the answer more precise, to improve the quality of the response, and to ensure that the resulting answer is as relevant and useful as possible. To clarify, here are 3 earlier prompts with these 2 components. Feel free to pause the video to take a closer look at them. Also good to know, creating suitable prompts to receive the best possible answers from an AI is known as prompt engineering. And this involves more than just the 2 components I have just introduced to you. Later in the video, I will introduce the other 4 components that you can optionally incorporate into your prompt to achieve the best possible result. I call this construct an advanced prompt. But first, I do not want to overcomplicate things. We will come back to this later in the video, so stay tuned. Before we delve further into the features of Gemini, I would like to show you the chat functions that can make the conversation with Gemini even more productive. One of the most sensible chat functions are drafts. With these, you can generate multiple answers for your task. Conveniently, you can also regenerate them whenever you want, which is very useful since you do not have to resend the prompt each time and can directly compare answers. Another useful feature is that you can listen to the message from Gemini. I will demonstrate this to you right now.
Absolutely. Here's a revised version of the sentence with the spelling and grammar issues addressed.
It is a really good feature to have while chatting. Below the message, you can modify your response. For example, you can change the tone of the message, be it casual, professional, or simple, depending on the task you have. You can also have Gemini write the answer shorter or longer, which is especially useful if you are working on a blog or something similar. I am going to generate this message shorter to demonstrate it to you. As you can see, it has now become shorter. Let's move on to the next chat function. Here, I have created a new chat with the question I posed to Gemini to show you the next function. It is called double check, with which you can verify your answer from Gemini using Google. This provides you with source references so you can check again yourself if the question has been accurately answered. Below, you can share your chat to Word, Gmail, or just as a link, which can also be very handy. After looking at how to share the chat, let's move on to another important function. With this function, you can edit your prompt again if you want to make changes without sending a new prompt. This is very sensible if you have made a mistake or want to improve it. As you can see, a new answer is generated directly that matches my new prompt. Now, I will show you what you can do on the sidebar to the left. You can already see that your messages are displayed there, where you can switch from one to another. When you navigate to a chat and click the 3 dots, you have options to delete and rename the chat. Moreover, what I really appreciate is that you can even pin your chat and assign an emoji to it so you can always find the chat quickly. As you can see here, I have pinned the chat with the Earth emoji fitting the theme, and thus can always find it quickly. Below, you can get help, view your chat activity, and go into your settings. In the settings, you can manage your subscription, enable real-time responses, change your theme, and manage your public links for the chats you have shared. At the very top, we have extensions that we can activate. We will get to those in a moment. I'll show you first how you can better summarize articles or posts without having to copy and paste the entire content. Since Gemini is part of Google, it can access the internet and perform Google searches, which means you can simply copy a link from your chosen article and add it directly to your prompt without copying the content. As you can see, I have added it to my prompt here, and Gemini even recognized it and transformed the link into the title. After sending the prompt, you can see that Gemini accesses the news through the internet and responds with a short summary of the news. Now let's move directly to the extensions. Currently, there are only these five: Google Flights, Google Hotels, Google Maps, Google Workspace, and YouTube. These connect you with the Google ecosystem, which is really handy. I will demonstrate each one to you, starting with Google Flights. For this, I enter the prompt here. Show me flights to Madrid to visit my aunt during the week of February 22. When searching for flights, the extension is triggered. And as you can see, it directly gives me a response with recommendations. It even recognized which airport is near me and directly recommended some flights, which I find really practical. Let me also demonstrate this with the Google Hotels extension. My prompt for this is, find hotels for a 4-day trip to San Francisco for New Year's Eve. Basically, the same principle applies here. As you can see, it gives me recommendations regarding hotels with descriptions and links. But now let's move on to my favorite extension. For this, I enter the prompt here. Where can I go to eat in Frankfurt? This triggers the Google Maps extension, which I find really useful. It gave me some good options for where I can eat. As you can see, there are many cool things possible with Gemini, but this is nothing compared to what's still to come. Most of you, I bet, will use the Google Workspace extension with which you can access your email, Drive, and Docs. I'll show you how this works. I'll start with the documents in my Drive. For this, I enter the prompt here. Find my document titled Weather in London from my Drive and summarize it. As you can see, this extension with Gemini accesses my Drive and my document and summarizes it, which is really useful. You probably already have some ideas on how this extension could make you more productive. Next, I give Gemini the prompt. Are there any new emails in my inbox? This will check Gmail to see if I have any new ones. It looks like I do not have any currently, but it shows me my last ones, which is also very cool. In my third prompt, I ask Gemini what's in my Drive. It lists them and even provides a description. Now, I'm coming to the last extension. With the YouTube extension, you can summarize videos on YouTube, grab general information about them, and much more. I'll show you this by taking one of my own videos and asking Gemini what it's about. You can already see that Gemini has given me an answer, but it made a few errors regarding the topic. That's why it's important that you always double-check the responses. Before I continue with the features, I will now conclude the topic of prompts so that you really know everything important about it, so you can generate the best answer for your task with Gemini. Since you are already familiar with the two components of task and details or context, I will now unveil the other four components, starting with tone and format. The tone determines the style in which the answer is written. For example, professional, clear, casual, simple, as you have already seen with the modify response in Gemini. With format, you decide the structure of your answer, whether it is an email, bullet points, tables, or even Python code. Here's an example prompt to better illustrate this. Task, compose a summary of the last meeting. Format, email. Details, context, including main topics, decisions, actions, and date time of the next meeting. Tone, in a clear and professional style. I believe through this example, you have understood what format and tone are, as they are also the simplest components. Now let us move on to the last two components, example and persona. Examples are given to Gemini so it has a template on how to solve your task more precisely according to your vision. An example for the prompt we have would be this one. We have essentially told Gemini what structure the email should be in, and it will then write the email that way since we have added an example to our prompt. You should always add an example if you want to tell Gemini exactly how to respond to something. A persona, in short, can improve the effectiveness and relevance of the generated answers. If you want your answer to be even more precise and specific, it is advisable to add one. Here is an example of how I added the persona to my prompt. You are the team coordinator who values precise and clear communication. By adding the persona, Gemini will solve my prompt even more precisely. So these four additional components that you can add to your prompt make what I call an advanced prompt. These are optional, and you can customize the positioning and use according to your needs. If you did not understand something about this topic, you can ask me on my Discord. I have even created a forum for prompts there and will soon share some. You can also share yours to help each other with prompting. Now, let us continue with what else you can do with Gemini. You can also create sheets with Gemini, which I frequently use, and then export them. It is a useful feature, but if you use it to perform mathematical tasks, for example, calculating the sum of something, Gemini can make many mistakes. If you are using it, always provide the numbers up front. Otherwise, Gemini can still make many errors regarding mathematics. If you do not want to type, you can also record your messages here. Let me demonstrate it for you. Hey Gemini, as you can see, Gemini has converted my voice into text. Now you just have to send it, and then it will provide an answer. A really cool feature is image recognition. For example, I can send my thumbnail and ask what can be seen on it, and it will describe it. It is important to note that it is not flawless. There are still numerous errors, but looking ahead, I envision it becoming incredibly useful, especially for more detailed analysis of graphs and visuals. I actually wanted to show you image creation, but unfortunately, it is not yet available in my country. However, you can see for yourself how it works by watching this Google video. Hopefully, it will become available for me too soon. For those of you lucky enough to be in the USA where you can use it, please send me some of the images you have generated on Discord. I would be curious to see the quality compared to DALL-E. Regarding coding, it is currently limited to handling minor tasks, offering assistance with small issues. However, it is prone to making numerous mistakes, so waiting for updates might be necessary. Nonetheless, I recommend giving it a try to see if it proves helpful for you. I hope I have been able to cover and demonstrate most of Gemini's features. Of course, there are many more, but going into all of them would unnecessarily extend the video. I want to leave you with this advice: do not overcomplicate things and just test and try out everything I have shown and taught you in the video. I am confident that with a bit of practice, you will truly find the best workflow with Gemini. For everyone who has stayed until the end of the video, I thank you. I have made the free document available on my Patreon and Discord for you. Check it out if you need quick support or a reminder of how things work. If you are interested in writing uncensored with an AI, take a look at this video. Thanks for watching.